Women all over the nation are on the front lines saving moms and babies. In this special EWTN Pro-Life Weekly episode, we take a look at women from different walks of life who have made this their mission. We'll start by taking a look back at the days just after Roe v. Wade fell. Two women, Drs. Christina Francis and Tara Sander Lee, joined us then to cut through the lies we were hearing from pro-abortion leaders. As the abortion industry continues to try and maintain their grip on the minds and hearts of young women, these two doctors work tirelessly to ensure that women have the real facts about their pregnancies, the dangers of the Planned Parenthood industry, and the reality of abortion. I'm joined now for medical analysis by Dr. Christina Francis, board member and CEO-elect at the Association of Pro-Life Obstetricians and Gynecologists, and Dr. Tara Sander Lee, senior fellow and director of life sciences at the Charlotte Lozier Institute. Dr. Francis, thanks for joining me. Delivering babies into the world is what you do day in and day out. So what was your initial reaction to the news of Roe's overturn?
Yeah, thank you, Prudence, for having me on to really celebrate this momentous decision with you and all of your viewers. You know, I was overjoyed on Friday when I heard the news and honestly a little dumbfounded that it actually happened. But, you know, the knowledge that now in this country, women and children have a chance at real health care as opposed to being subject to the restrictions that Roe placed on states to be able to protect the safety of the women and children in their state. Just overjoyed that now we're going to be able to have real discussions on a state level, and that all of those pro-life physicians that have gone ahead of me, APLOG, the organization that I work with, came into existence the year that Roe was decided. And in the 49 years since then, all of my mentors that have gone ahead of me have worked so hard towards this day. And so it was just a wonderful day to know that the work and the voices of these pro-life physicians had finally paid off.
I think overjoyed is the perfect way to put it. And Dr. Lee, thank you for joining us as well. You have joined us many times here on Pro-Life Weekly, bringing us the scientific facts that demand that these unborn children be protected under the law. What's going through your head right now?
You know, again, thank you so much for having me, Prudence. And this is an incredible moment of celebration. I mean, Roe and Casey were an egregious wrong in the history of America. And, you know, as I've said many times on this show, science reveals the truth about how each one of these babies developing inside the womb is a human being from conception until birth that should be protected. And now the American people, through their elected officials at the state and federal level, can finally have their voice heard. I mean, in states where abortion is now illegal, abortion clinics are closing, pregnancy help centers are providing material needs and help to women that desperately need it if they're facing an unexpected pregnancy. Lives are being saved, and hearts as early as 6 weeks are now beating that would have been stopped if not for the Dobbs decision last Friday. So this is a huge win, and we are so excited.
Yes, praise God for that. And ladies, I want to talk about some misinformation we're hearing regarding ectopic pregnancies. Pro-abortion politicians and reporters are saying that the Roe decision means that women won't be able to get the treatment they need if they experience this complication. Dr. Francis, I want to start with you. Can you just explain what an ectopic pregnancy is and what the treatment would be? Are these claims from the pro-abortion side true?
Yes, absolutely. You know, my heart has been breaking over the last few days as I see this misinformation really being spread. And I think a lot of women are legitimately feeling scared that they're not going to be able to receive life-saving treatment when they need it. So an ectopic pregnancy, put simply, is a pregnancy where the embryo has implanted somewhere outside of the uterus where it's not supposed to be. And these pregnancies are a legitimate threat to the life of the mother. Ectopic pregnancies are still the leading cause of maternal mortality in the first trimester. So there's a very real situations that we have to deal with. But treating an ectopic pregnancy is not the same thing as an abortion. The only intent of an abortion is to intentionally end the life of that embryonic or fetal human being, of that preborn child. That's not our intent when we treat an ectopic pregnancy. And in fact, we use completely different procedures to treat an ectopic pregnancy than physicians use to do induced abortions. And so these procedures will in no way be restricted by state laws that restrict abortion. In fact, many state laws specifically accept ectopic pregnancies out of the law. And even pre-Roe, in states where abortion was illegal, physicians were not restricted in their ability to take care of ectopic pregnancies. So, you know, this message needs to stop being spread. I'm a pro-life physician. I've never needed to do an abortion to adequately treat my patients or to save the life of my maternal patient. And yet I treat ectopic pregnancies all the time.
All of this is so important, and I'm so thankful to have had you both on the show today. Dr. Tara Sanderly and Dr. Christina Francis, thank you so much.